Good morning, students. Today, let us learn a lesson from poetry, that is from modern times. This lesson is about Sri Mythili Saran Gupta Ji. Mythili Saran Gupta Ji, Adhunika Hindi Kavita Ome, Adhunika Hindi Kavita Ke Kshetra Me, Bahut Hi Naam Kamaye The. Inka बहु भाषाओं पर अधिकार है, उनके बारे में थोड़ा जानकारी ले लेंगे और बाद में लेसन में हम प्रवेश करेंगे. श्री मैथिली शरण गुप्त सन 1886 में पैदा हुए थे और 1964 में उनका देहांत हो गया. श्री मैथिली शरण गुप्त जी के बारे में थोड़ी समाचार सीख लेंगे. सन 1886 में झांसी के करीब चिरगांव में जन्मे मैथिली शरण गुप्त अपने जीवन काल में ही राष्ट्र कवि के रूप में विख्यात हुए. मैथिली शरण गुप्त जी का एक अटूट नाता है राष्ट्र कवि के रूप में. राष्ट्र कवि मीन्स ए नेशनल पोएट. He is said to be a national poet, though he is totally related to Hindi Sahitya. ये राष्ट्रकवि के रूप में चिरगांव में पैदा हुए थे और अपनी शिक्षा दीक्षा घर पर ही कर चुके थे. संस्कृत, बंगाल, मराठी और अंग्रेजी पर इनका समान अधिकार था. This is to say that he is a multilingual poet. He has known Sanskrit, Bengal, Marathi and English languages as well as Hindi language. Gupta ji Ram Bhakt Kavi hai. It is said that he was a devotional poet of Rama. Ram ka kirti gaan inka chira sanchit abhilasha rahi. He always wanted to praise Rama in his poetry. That means in his works he wanted to show his devotion towards Sri Ram. इन्होंने भारतीय जीवन को समग्रता में समझने और प्रस्तुत करने का भी प्रयास किया. Now he wanted to make the integrated India's picture in his poetry. That means India is one. India is incredible. That is what Kavi wanted to show, Kavi wanted to prove through his themes of poems. Gupta ji ki kavita ka bhasha vishuddha khadi boli hai. Khadi boli is the other name of modern Hindi. It is said that Gupta ji used mostly his say kavita with modern Hindi language. Bhasha par Sanskrit ka prabhav hai. It is said that Sanskrit language also influenced his style of writing. Kavya ki katha vastu Bharatiya itihas ke aise amshon se li gayi hai jo Bharat ke atit ka swarna chitra pathak ke samne upasthit karte hain. Mostly his themes were about the past of India, and this past of India also he wanted to make a clear picture that the present generations should know the golden history of our country. That's why it is said that samagrata ko samajhna itihas ke amsh swarna chitra. Such words are used here. What is swarna chitra? The golden picture. The picture that is a memorable picture of past India, he wanted to put it in front of the say readers in his poetry. Gupta ji ki pramukh krutiya hain. Krutiya means say literary work is called kriti. Saket, Yashodhara, Jayadrada, Vath. Three main books are noted for his literary works. They are Saket, Yashodhara and Jayadrada Vath. Gupta ji ke pita Seth Ramcharan Das bhi kavi the. It is known that his father also was a poet. Inke chote bhai Siyaram Charan Gupta bhi prasiddha kavi huye. Not only his father, even his younger brother Siyaram Charan Gupta. These two also are well-known poets in Hindi language. So, the whole family of Mythili Charan Gupta comes under poets family. Now, let us see the lesson we are going to read today. This can be read under the heading Patha Pravesh. Prakruti ke anya praniyon ki tulna mein manushya mein chetana shakti ki prabalata hoti hi hai. See, once we compare humans along with the other factors of nature, the word chetana shakti, what is meant by chetana shakti? The life or the motivation of humans with a kind of say awakening, that is chetana. This also comes under the say capacity of moving and making movement in others. This is mostly seen in say humans when you compare to other beings. वह अपने ही नहीं औरों के हिताहित का भी ख्याल रखने में औरों के लिए भी कुछ कर सकने में समर्थ होता है. मैन इज एम्पावर्ड चिल्ड्रन टू टेक केयर ऑफ नॉट ओनली हिमसेल्फ बट ऑल्सो हिज फेलो बीइंग्स. मे बी द गुड द बैड द प्रॉब्लम्स एंड द हैप्पीनेस एवरीथिंग ही वॉन्ट्स टू शेयर विद अदर फेलो बीइंग्स इन अ सोसाइटी. पशु चरागाह में जाते हैं, अपने अपने हिस्से का चर आते हैं, पर मनुष्य ऐसा नहीं करता. अकॉर्डिंग टू मैथिली शरण गुप्त, एनिमल्स गो एंड ग्रेस इन द मेडोस बट दे गो टू ए पर्टिकुलर पार्ट वेर दे वॉन्ट टू ग्रेस एंड दे कम बैक. बट ह्यूमन्स आर नॉट लाइक दैट. ह्यूमन्स ऑलवेज टेक केयर ऑफ द फेलो बीइंग्स. वह जो कमाता है, जो भी कुछ उत्पादित करता है, वह औरों के लिए भी करता है, औरों के सहयोग से करता है. इट इज़ वेरी क्लियरली डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय कवि दैट मैन इज गोइंग टू डू एनी वर्क लाइक प्रोडक्शन और लाइक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और वट एवर इट इज़ ही इज़ डूइंग नॉट ओनली फॉर हिज सेक बट ऑल्सो टू से मेक ए बेनिफिट टू द सोसाइटी. सो वी से human beings are said to be social animals. He wants to live with others, he wants to live with the help of others. He works for the society and society also cares for individuals. This is what Mythili Charan Gupta says, that particular society can be called the best of its type. Prastut Patika कवि अपनों के लिए जीने मरने वालों को मनुष्य तो मानते हैं, लेकिन यह मानने को तैयार नहीं है कि ऐसे मनुष्यों में मनुष्यता के पूरे पूरे लक्षण भी हैं. इन दिस पोयम पर्टिकुलरली कवि वॉन्ट्स टू से एक्सप्रेस हिज फीलिंग्स. वॉट इज हिज फीलिंग? या पीपल टेक बर्थ डाई, टेक बर्थ डाई, बट people are people when they do it only for not only their sake but also for the society's sake, and they should have all the characters that they have humanity in them. If humanity is missing, we cannot take a person into consideration like a human being. That is what Kavi wants to focus here. Yes, there are people who are taking birth, who are leaving this world, and some more people are coming and going. But a person who has a concern, who has the attention towards even fellow beings, then only he is said to be a perfect human being. Have you understood? On this basis only our kavita manushyata will go on. वह तो उन मनुष्यों को ही महान मानेगा जिनमें अपने और अपनों के हित चिंतन से कहीं पहले और सर्वोपरि दूसरों का हित चिंतन हो. कवि ऑल्सो सेज दैट ही इज सेट टू बी द बेस्ट इंडिविजुअल, ही सेट टू बी द बेस्ट ह्यूमन हु ऑलवेज टेक्स द कंसर्न ऑफ fellow beings, and later he takes the concern of himself. That means paropakara chintan should be higher in any aspect of a human's life. That is what Kavi defines in this poem. Usme ve guno ko hi jinke karan ko ye manushya is mrityu lok se gaman kar jane ke bavajud yugon tak auron ki yaad mein bhi bana reh pata hai. Kavi is telling one more thing. One who lives like that, that means beyond his individual, beyond his personal concerns, when he cares for the other people in the society, his name will be taken with a lot of respect, a lot of concern in this world. Even if he dies, he will become, say, alive for ever and ever. That is only called real humanity according to the poet. Uski mrityu bhi sumrityu ho jati hai. Then even if he dies, it is going to be celebrated by the people. Yes, we know the death of a person is not a celebration, but when a great person who always cares for others, who always has a concern for fellow beings, his mrityu will be called sumrityu. Sumrityu meaning the best of its type, death. And Kavi wants to tell what are the characters one should possess once he wanted to be identified like a real human being. That is what we are going to learn from this Kavita. Now let us see the title of Kavita, that is Manushyata. Manushyata means humanity. That means the supermost character of a human is called Manushyata. Just taking birth and dying is not Manushyata. Manushyata is something different as per the definition of Mythili Saran Guptaji. And let us see the stanzas. Children, before I start the lesson, I want to tell you one thing. Guptaji ki kavita aisi hoti hai, ye gaane ke layak bhi rehta hai. Isme ek rhythm rehta hai, rhythm. I think all of you know rhythm. The last words of each line are almost similar, and that gives us a scope of singing. It's like a beautiful song, we can sing it. Now, let me read the first stanza for you, how it is melodious to sing. Vicharaloki martya ho na mrutyu se daro kabhi maro parantu yo maro ki yaad jo kare sabhi. Are you getting? Are you experiencing the rhythm? Huyi nayo sumrutyu to vrudha mare vrudha jiye mara nahi vahi ki jo jiya na aap ke liye vahi pashu pravrutti hai ki aap hi chare वही मनुष्य है कि जो मनुष्य के लिए मरे. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू एनालाइज दीज लाइन्स. विचार लो कि मर्त्य हो न मृत्यु सो डरो कभी. कवि इज टेलिंग थिंक वो ह्यूमन बीइंग्स थिंक वंस. यस यू आर बॉर्न लाइक ए मर्त्य. मर्त्य मीन्स मानव. मानव मीन्स ए ह्यूमन बीइंग. Na mrutyu se daro kabhi, never get scared of death. We are born like humans, and one day everybody should die. Never, never get scared of death. Maro parantu yo maro ki yaad jo kare sabhi. Yes, one day we have to die, but you have to die in such a way everybody takes your name when you die, and after you leave this world also forever. That means one should be remembered by all the people in the surroundings, so that he will be titled as a real and a perfect human being. Okay, kabhi bhi mrityu se nahi darna, agar mare to bhi sabke yaadgar mein aisa jinda reh jana. That is what Kavi wanted to tell you. Huyi nayo sumrutyu to vrudha mare vrudha jiye. When we are not getting the best of the death, that means when we are not dying in a best way, so Kavi says that it is a waste of taking birth and even leaving this world. Mara nahi wahi ki jo jiyan aapke liye. Suppose a person has died and he is not said to be dead because he always lived for others. He never lived for himself. We call him, he is the person who never dies in the memories of people. He is always alive. Kavi wants everybody to live in that particular manner. Vahi pashu pravrutti hai ki aap aap hi chare. Yeah, what we see in the nature, animals will graze in the fields, animals will graze in the meadows, and these animals are, say, different from humans in particular way that when they go for grazing, they select one place, they select their own part, and they come out. They never care for the other animal, or they never get into other animal's place, or they are never bothered about the next animal. Vahi manushya hai ki jo manushya ke liye mare. So this is what said to be the title line of the, say, kavita, and this will be repeated after every stanza. Kavi is telling yehi baat jo manushya dusron ke liye marta hai, dusron ke liye jeeta hai, wahi manushya hota hai. Who lives for others, dies for others, only can be called manushya. Only can be called the perfect human. Understood? This is what Kavi wanted to focus in all the stanzas, giving different aspects of human life. Let's go to the next stanza. See, I'll sing it in a rhythmic way for you people. Listen. Usi udar ki katha Saraswati bakhanati. Saraswati. Who is Saraswati? She is the goddess of education. She is the goddess of knowledge. This Saraswati will define, Saraswati will sing, Saraswati will describe in her own words about a person who is said to be udar. Udar means a wide-hearted person, a person with a broad thinking, and a person whose life is full of concern for others. Usi udar se dhara krutardha bhava manati. Even the earth feels very, very proud, very happy when such people are born on her. When such concerned people for the society are born on her, she feels herself very much satisfied. And she feels, my life is totally successful. That is what the earth feels when such wide-hearted people are born. Usi udar ki sada sajiva kirti kujati. We know people, even birds, animals, everybody will take the name of that particular udar person. Udar means who is so much concerned for not only himself, but also like himself, all other people in the society. Uski sajiva kirti kujati. Kujiti means praised, sung by different, say, beings in the world about that great person. Tatha usi udar ko samasta srushti pujati. Yeah, it's not only praising him, but also people worship him. People take his name with a lot of respect, with a lot of reverence, with a lot of, tell you, great memory in their mind. They worship him like a god. They worship him in the other form of God. Akhand atma bhava jo asima vishwame bhare, vahi manushya hai ki jo manushya ke liye mare. Manushya ke liye jo jeeta hai, manushya ke liye jo marta hai, uska akhand atma bhav. What is akhand atma bhav? That is, all people are in me, I am in all people. That is what we say, an integrated feeling of humanity. What we see today in the society is totally different. We see mostly the, say, selfish motives, selfish attitudes, and we cannot make such kind of selfish activities into, say, respectable or a reverent way from any aspect of life. Kavi tells, who feels in himself everybody and in everybody himself, that is only called, say, manushyata. Such manushyata or such manush, manav, only is called manav. That kind of feeling is only called humanity. So, try to understand the, say, deep feeling of Kavi, who lives and dies, who works and who tries to highlight the society in him and in him, the whole society. Such person is only called manushya. Kshudarth ranti devane diya karasta thalibhi. Here Kavi wants to exemplify some people. We have seen the history, we have seen our, say, great books of ethics, epics, and also historical information. We have seen many, many things. Kavi wants to talk about some great people who lived like real humans. The first example he is giving is Rantidev. Rantidev is a Raja. I think you know his name at least. Rantidev was said to be a supermost dani. Dani means a charitable person. A person who has given the plate of meals which he was about to eat when some beggar has come to him. Kshudarth. Kshudarth means who was suffering from hunger, who was, say, so much of in need of food. Rantidev was about to eat his own meals. He gave it away to the beggar. Kshudarth Rantidev ne diya karasta thalibi. Rantidev, who is a Raja and who was in a very bad time, he wanted to just have his food, and at the same time a beggar has approached him. By seeing the beggar in a very sad, pathetic state, Rantidev, he gave off his plate of meals to the beggar who was suffering from hunger. That means he, being very hungry, he gave off his plate of meals to the, say, person who is suffering in front of him. Tada dadhichi ne diya pararth astijalabhi. Dadhichi, do you, say, know the name of Dadhichi? Dadhichi was a great sage. He was a monk. He was a Maharshi. Dadhichi Maharshi has given even his astijal. What is astijal? The bones. The bones of his body, when all the gods went to him in search of his bones. You know, with those bones, there was a weapon called Vajrayudha was prepared. All gods sent, say, Indra to beg him his astijal. This is for, say, the benefit of the universe, but not somebody's selfish motive. And Dadhichi was ready to give happily even his bones. Even his body, he wanted to, say, die through yoga and gave him. Ushinara kshitishne swamamsa dhanabhi kiya. And one more king, Ushinara. Ushinara was a king who has given his own flesh. He cut his body and gave his flesh to the person who was in need of some flesh. And in place of a bird that was to be saved by the Raja, Raja offered his own flesh. Let us see what is the wide broad look of these people. Their, say, look itself, their thinking process itself is broader and broader and broader. Saharsha Veera Karnane Sharira Charmabhidiya. And we know from Mahabharata very well about Karna. He was said to be Dani. Mahadani Karna, when Indra went to him, Indra requested him, please, I want your ear rings and your kavacha. Kavacha is something to protect his own body. please give me your kavacha and kundala as a offering to me, please. Then Karna was not at all hesitating. He was ready to offer that.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.